Well, these cool mornings in the meantime, they make you crave some comfort foods, and you may find some inspiration in a new cookbook called Giada at Home. And Giada De Laurentiis is joining us now live from New York City, the Food Network star. Good morning, Giada.
Good morning, Deirdre. How are you?
I'm doing great. I have a quick story for you. My four-year-old, I was passing by the living room a couple weeks ago, and he is staring at one of your shows. He's like 6 inches from the TV, and I said, what are you doing? He says, I'm watching Giada. I love her. And then he goes, I don't know what it is about her, but I sure like her, and Daddy does, too.
Oh, my goodness.
So
That is the best thing I've heard all day.
He's a big fan, and so many people are. We've got a lot of really great Facebook questions. Do you mind taking a couple of those first, and then we'll talk about your new book? Okay, so Carol Kiero Schulminger says, when will your new cookbook be coming out?
It's out. It's actually been out for a while. It's been out since April.
All right, well, that's an easy one to answer. Here's one from Adam Cook. This one's going to go in a different direction. I love her, not in a stalker-esque way, but close. Anyway, as far as I know, she doesn't have any restaurants. Any chance you would be opening up a place?
You know, I don't have any restaurants, and right now I don't have any in the plans.
Okay.
But something new to tell him is that I do have a whole line of cookware and food available at Target. So he can kind of get a little more of me if he goes to his local Target store.
Yes, actually, the four-year-old pointed that out to me last weekend at Target.
And
one more Facebook question for you, and that is, could you do some more shows centered around bacon? That's from Anthony Rodriguez, and he follows that up with, will you marry me? But you're kind of taken.
Yes, I am married, and I would say, Anthony, that that is what my husband asks for every day.
Interesting.
More recipes with bacon. So bacon, pancetta, which is more Italian, yes, I will make more recipes with bacon or pancetta.
What are you stirring up right there?
I'm making some butternut squash soup, actually, because it's one of my favorite ingredients during the fall season. And I think it's really fun to take your kids to your local grocery store, farmer's market, and even in your area, Target, that has fresh produce. And I like to get my daughter and my nephew involved in peeling the butternut squash and kind of helping me in the kitchen to really enjoy the meals that they end up in eating. So it's one of my favorites.
Now, you know, that's interesting. You just were peeling the squash. Is that how you get to the meat of the squash? Because I've always actually cut it out. Is that not the best way to do it?
You can cut it. You can use a nice sharp knife, and you can cut the ends just to make sure it's stable, and then you can kind of cut the skin off. But with this vegetable peeler, which actually swivels, which happens to be mine, you can kind of peel. You see how well it comes right off? And when it comes to kids and involving them in it, it's easier to give them a vegetable peeler than it is to have them cut with a knife.
That's why,
in my opinion, if you want to get the kids involved, the vegetable peeler is the way to go. And because this one swivels, it makes it really easy.
I was reading your blog this morning, and you were recently in Tahoe. In fact, you enjoyed a wet woody at Garwoods. For a lot of people in Northern California, it's a tradition and a wonderful way to kill an afternoon.
That's right. It is. It's a lot of fun. And yes, we had a blast. My daughter came, and it was just, we enjoyed cooking together so much. It was a fabulous family vacation.
You know, it seems like you're pretty much everywhere these days. You've got the food line. You've got all the shows on the Food Network, the books, and certainly being a working mom. What is the hardest thing right now about being so well-recognized and liked by such a variety of people?
You know, I think the hardest thing for me is managing the time and spending enough time with my family and my daughter and also, you know, working. So that I think it's always managing in time. I take it one day at a time. And that's kind of the best way to sort of to do it. It's just to take one day at a time, and I breathe a lot.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
But, you know, for people like Anthony who need to get more of me, Target's the place to go.
Head to Target, Anthony. Like it. Thanks very much. And we do have a link to Giada's blog, which is actually a really fun read. You'll find it at kcradio.com/morningnews. We'll see you later.